How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? Let me talk to you about what's happening today, about the New York Times and the story about John McCain. Now, if you happen to be a liberal and you're a supporter of the New York Times, there's nothing anybody could say or do that'll be disturbing to you. You don't care what the Times does. They destroy an innocent man. You say to yourself, well, there must have been something to it, and you forget about it. When Senator McCarthy was destroying liberal people and legitimate people, and he was calling them communists when they had nothing to do with it, all the liberal organizations of America and every decent person, everybody who believed in democracy and everybody who cared about humanity was saying that he's destroying human life and he should be killed, he should be murdered. There's something horrible about America. We're going down the drain as a country if we could allow this to happen. The outrage was unbelievable, and to this day we know that it was the dirtiest, filthiest chapter in American history when decent people were destroyed by Senator McCarthy. Now, when the New York Times does the same thing to an innocent man like Senator McCain, where's the outrage? Where's the people who felt it was disgusting to destroy innocent, decent people? Where are you? How come there's no outrage from the phony liberals and from the supposedly decent people who care so much about democracy? How come democracy doesn't count when Senator McCain is about? These are supposed to be humanitarians who care so much about the underdog and the underprivileged and everybody who they fight the Republicans because the Republicans supposedly are inhuman and unconcerned about people. So how come people don't mean nothing to you if it's somehow the man is a Republican? All of a sudden he's not human. All of a sudden the New York Times has a right to destroy this man with a concocted story based on absolutely nothing, just because they wanted to set him up to be destroyed. First they say he's their favorite of all the Republicans because he's such a wonderful person. Now that he's an opponent of their men, Barack Obama or Hillary, now they say it's time to destroy this guy. So we don't need any evidence. All we know is that he looked at a girl, he talked to a girl, he almost saw a girl, and he almost, if somebody said to him, don't go out with that girl, and he said, ha-ha, somebody said don't go out with her. What if somebody told you that don't go to China? Does it mean you were there because somebody told you not to? Somebody told you, you see that hula house? Don't go in there. Does that mean the man was in the hula house because somebody told him not to go there? How disgusting could you become, and how vulgar and ugly could you be just to prove a point to destroy somebody because he's on your other party? If you want a dictatorship of one party and the other guy's party shouldn't exist, and you want to destroy human life and it means nothing all of a sudden, how come the same New York Times didn't find anything wrong with the whole story of Clinton's indiscretions and filthy behavior, and it was never on the front page? Paula Jones was never on the front page. This Yenta Flowers story was never on the front page. None of his indiscretions and none of his campaigns to destroy women was ever on the front page. There's one case with Marina Broderick, which was an out-and-out rape case, never made the front page. None of the real hateful behavior and the disgusting character of Clinton was never on the front page. But this is a story that didn't even happen. They have no proof that it happened. And they try to destroy an innocent man. Why? Because they're filthy people. And the people who support the New York Times are just as filthy as he is, as they are. And you're all filthy people. You don't believe in democracy except when it serves your own purposes. The filth and the vulgarity of the supposed Democrats who can't even find anything wrong with what just happened makes you, I'm so nauseous I can't even finish talking about it. You don't belong in this country if you don't believe in democracy. And you don't belong to the New York Times shouldn't exist as a paper. They should be in court and they should be convicted. They should be put in jail. That's where they belong. With you together if you believe in them.